Good evening, candidates. This is regarding Indian Bank probationary officer in JMG scale 1 appointment. These those who have been selected under IBPS selection examination in 2019 and after the interview, those who have been selected, they are given this letter and they have been asked to report at the required respective zonal office on 5th of October. Before that, they have to return a copy of this provisional appointment order duly signed by them to the HRM department. Here, what are the points given? One, you are eligible upon joining the bank. The basic pay will be ₹23,700 per mensem in junior management grade in the scale of 23,700 to 42,020, and you are entitled to annual increments, dearness allowance, and other allowances as may be admissible from time to time on a ad hoc basis till the Indian Bank Service Regulations is amended. So this is the basic pay. With the DA and all, I think you will be crossing 30,000-35,000 depending on the place of posting. Period of probation, you will be on probation for a period of 2 years from the date of joining. In the case of this Indian Bank, they are taking the date of your reporting as date of joining, and from that date onwards, you will be given online training which you can attend from the zonal office to which you have reported using your tablet or your laptop. And or you can attend this training from staying at your home also. Okay, this is the point. Next point, place of service, you can be posted anywhere in India. That is the point. Then rules of service, they have given you certain rules by which you are governed. Then it is also given you are governed by new national pension system, NPS, for which you have to become a member and for which what you have to do in case you have been working somewhere else, you can continue that. It is also stated that that rupees 15 per staff member dying in harness, the employee has to contribute, that is as a welfare scheme compulsorily from the employees of the bank. Then you here it is also given you shall not leave or discontinue your service without giving in notice in writing of your intention to leave. The period of notice required is 3 months of active service, and you shall execute an indemnity bond with the surety undertaking to serve the bank for a minimum period of 2 years. So that is, if you intend to leave or discontinue the service, resign from the service of the bank before completion of 2 years, you shall reimburse the bond amount 1 lakh. So in the bond for officers, you will put 1 lakh. And after completion of 2 years means unserved notice period only. And before 2 years means 1 lakh plus unserved notice period. You are supposed to give 3 months notice. If you are not giving any notice, then you have to give 3 months salary also. What are the forms to be downloaded from the website www.indianbank.in? That is the thing from where you have to download the documents. You have to download the documents. I think you have to go to career. You have to click career. And in the career, recruitment of probationary officers, announcement, advertisement regarding chief, that is different, regarding dip, that is different. This is also different, recruitment security guard, public notice, result of this is also different. Yeah, recruitment of probationary officers, that is also separate, specialist officers separate. Download of forms, here only you have to download. What are the documents they want you to download? Number one, biodata form. you have to download that biodata form. This is the biodata form you have to fill in. Please go through the instructions provided over leave and follow them meticulously. Candidate should fill up the details in his or her own handwriting. Name, appointment, regular selection, IBPS, you have to tick IBPS, probationary officer, date of written test, if you remember, you give that. Date of interview, if you remember, you give that. Then SR number, this will not be filled by the candidate. This, the branch, the HRM will fill it up. Here simply you have to, here only, this one only you will fill it up. This will be filled up by HRM, and instructions for filling up the biodata form that is given here. Please go through that. Checklist of documents and all they are given. You have to go through this checklist of document. Master data collection, name, additional details, same thing. The date of birth, male or female, marital status. If you are married, you tell that you are married. And that is what it is. Then birthplace, where you were born. How many people are dependent on you? That also, of which dependent, how many number of children. In case you have children, that may not arise here. Then state, this also, religion also, languages known also. Then native place. This is required to be given because, say, in the case of leave travel concession, you are entitled to go to your native place once in 2 years for that. Bond data, type of bond, probationary officer, bond signed date, start date, bond period. Amount is rupees 1 lakh. Your name, full signature you have to give. Category details, if you belong to SCST or OBC or EWS, if you are belonging to ex-serviceman. Details of relatives working in Indian Bank. If any of your uncle, aunt, cousin is working in Indian Bank, you have to give details. Extracurricular activities that you are doing. If you have achieved something, you can mention. Honorary post and all, this may not apply. Sports quota. Yeah. Persons with disability. Then address detail, permanent address, present address, you should give properly. Attested copy of any one of the following document as proof of address, say driving license or Aadhaar card or voter ID or passport copy or postal identity card. If some people do not have Aadhaar card, etc., because they have shifted their residence recently, it is better to obtain go from the post office postal identity card. Then phone number in case of emergency you have to give. Details of family members you have to give. Say brothers, sisters, sons, daughters, etc. Then parents details you have to give. Father's name, mother's name, father's date of birth, mother's date of birth. What is the occupation of father, mother? Details of the employer of father, mother. Monthly income or pension that they are drawing. This is required to determine about the dependency on you. Family member, supposing you are a married person, you will give these details. Educational qualifications, you have to give name of the course, SSC, the name of the institute, percentage of marks, main subject, university, board, number of attempts, date of passing, full time or part time or correspondent, attested copy you have to give. Post graduation, doctorate, anything you have to give. If you have already passed JAAB or AAB London, you can mention it here. Other qualification of diploma, you can give it here. Then details of previous employment, this may not apply for majority candidates, you have to give that. Then details of personal ID, your email ID, your mobile number that you are using, income tax PAN number, driving license number, voter ID number, passport number, you have to give. details of police verification, nearest police station, address you have to give. Permanent address, supposing your permanent address is different from present address, you have to give two police station address. Full address of university, etc., you have to give for UG and PG. Any additional data you can give. Other details, names of places where you have lived in the last 10 years. Last 10 years. Have you been arrested? No. Have you ever been debarred? No. Is any case pending in court of law? No. Is any case pending against university? No. If there is anything, you have to give. Name occupation of two respectable persons. See, you have to give the address of two people, respectable people known to you, so that the bank can write to them. Details of immovable property. Do you own any immovable property in your name or spouse name or my father's name, mother's name? You have to give that. Declaration, you have to fill it up. This is not to be filled by the candidate. So this is known as biodata form. Next form, indemnity bond. This is the indemnity bond already downloaded. Already downloaded and kept here. This is the indemnity bond. Here it is very simple. You will write this indemnity is made at say Coimbatore or Chennai on this date. You are going to execute it before coming for appointment. So it will be prior to that date. And I suggest you take it on 100 rupees stamp paper, non-judicial stamp paper. Then you will write here, you will write your address, permanent resident address, full address you have to give, and your employee. And it will be your father or mother or uncle or auntie who is going to give surety at their address. The term employee will mean the employee. Surety will mean father or mother or uncle. Then employer bank is Indian Bank. Whereas the employee has been selected for appointment as probationary officer in scale 1. Employee YD appointment letter number. I think that letter number is given. Here letter number and all, it will be there in the top of the letter. You can give that one. And date also. Whereas in the acceptance, the employer of the bank has already been communicated. Date of signing, acceptance letter. See, this appointment order you would have signed on some other date. That date you have to give. Then here the party of the second part, that is the surety, and rupees 1 lakh. It is only 1 lakh. All other places 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 lakh. 2 years you are supposed to serve without leaving from the date of appointment, including training period. And in case you resign before 2 years, you have to give 1 lakh, not only 1 lakh, plus notice period if you are not able to serve, salary for that also. You have to sign for employee surety, and this should be witnessed by two people who know the employee and also surety. They will have to sign. Okay, good. Now I was telling you about download of document, indemnity over. Then there is one attestation form. Indemnity bond is okay. Attestation form. This is the attestation form I am downloading. Attestation form is what? Here, this your photo has to be affixed. It should be signed by this is to be signed by you only, attestation. Same thing again and again they will ask. You have to fill it up and give. Okay, no problem. Service joining report. Service joining report. This also you have to download. Yeah, same thing. You just fill it up and give. Kuch taklif nahi. Even if you write wrong, I mean, well, whatever documents you are taking, you better take in fidelity, secrecy. You take two copies so that one copy is spoiled, you can use the other copy. You cannot be going and requesting somebody there. Samajh gaya? Okay. Then fitness certificate to be obtained from a qualified doctor of rank not less than civil surgeon. If you know somebody working in government office, government hospital, civil surgeon, you can get it attested by him. And what is the medical certificate format is there? Testimonial from two respectable persons. This is the conduct character certificate. This is to certify that so-and-so residing is known to me for the past so many years, and to the best of my knowledge and belief, he or she bears good conduct and character and has no antecedents which render him unsuitable for bank employment. This is very useful. I will download this because many candidates ask me, sir, what is the conduct certificate format? So this format can be used by all bank employees or others. Conduct certificate, Indian Bank, I will put it, can be used by other bank or people also. Somebody should give this conduct certificate to people not related to you. If there is seal, better get it done by some bank manager or bank officer, and he should give his residential address also. Next, testimonials to respectable persons that I have already told. Please submit the above forms duly filled in. You have to take everything duly filled in by you along with you. Then at the time of joining, you have to produce the following documents. SSLC mark sheet, 10th class mark sheet, passing certificate. Intermediate or higher secondary mark sheet, passing certificate. University mark sheets, university degree certificate. Mark sheet of passing certificate of all other educational technical qualifications. If suppose that may not be there for many people. Photo identity proof and address proof. Aadhaar card, driving license, something. So whatever original document you are going to show them, take up better two copies. One copy you will give them, one copy you retain with you. In case you are working relieving certificate, then PAN card. Then if you belong to SCST, OBC, EWS, you have to get a certificate as per IBPS format. In case a person is having some disability, he has to produce that certificate from the doctor also. You have to give 5 copies of recent passport size photograph. Better give the photograph that you have affixed in the IBPS format also. And 3 copies of stamp size photograph also. 5 passport, 3 stamp size. And you are supposed to report at 5:10 at the zonal office. Okay. And here they have given, you will undergo 4-week online induction training program before you are being posted to the branch. They will inform you where you should go. You are supposed to have your own laptop or tablet or compatible mobile device with which you can attend the training program. My recommendation will be, if you are living in a city in zonal office and all, if it is not inconvenient, you attend in zonal office itself. Because if you go and reside in your house and all, there may be sometime power, there may be not be internet current. But if you have got good facility, you can go to your home also, enjoy, get salary also. You are supposed to give acceptance letter, and this should reach them before 28th September. You have to report on 5th October. This is probationary officer, Indian Bank, my bank. Yeah, the bank in which I served 32 years roughly and took VRS, and the bank which is taking care of me from my 19th year. Thank you, Indian Bank. Thank you, Bhagwan. Thank you so much. I wish the best of luck to the candidates.